Amidst the glamour and extravagance of luxury yacht excursions, a dark, dark allegation surfaces, casting a shadow over a renowned music mogul, we all known as P. Diddy, and his son. As a lawsuit unfolds, accusation of a hedonistic getaway turned sinister threatens to unravel the fabric of a high-profile family's legacy. Stay tuned as we'll unravel this whole saga. You all are welcome, welcome, welcome back to my channel. My name is Femi Ayodele, and you are welcome back to Life Mosaic, right? So, what are we talking about today? We are talking about P. Diddy's son, Christian King Combs, the lawsuit that was filed against him. Christian King Combs, the son of rapper Sean Diddy Combs, has been accused of sexually assaulting a lady, Grace O. McKay. I hope I'm pronouncing the name correctly. McKay, on a yacht, during a family holiday in St. Martin in 2022, according to a lawsuit that was filed in Los Angeles. I think it was last week that lawsuit was filed. Grace, who worked as a steward on the yacht, alleged that the environment on that vessel was filled with intoxicated people, suspected ex-workers, celebrities, and a lot of substance use, right? She also suspected that drinks may have been spiked, meaning they might have laced their drinks with some, you know, substances. The lawsuit details that Christian Combs became aggressive after insisting that Grace drinks tequila with him, subsequently grabbing her and trying to kiss her. Another claim in the lawsuit states, very well, give me a minute. So, another claim in the lawsuit states that Christian tried to force her into performing oral, you know what I mean, in the yacht cinema. When Grace reported the incidents, she claimed the complaint was ignored and that Sean Combs bribed the crew to keep quiet. Sean Combs, who also faces other serious SA allegations and a federal ST probe, is named in the lawsuit. Whew. Problems upon problems here and there for P. Diddy, right? For premises liability, as he was the one who chartered the yacht. The complaint accuses him of turning the family into, or the family excursion into, a hedonistic environment. And guess what? Their lawyer, Aaron Dyer, has dismissed these allegations as lewd and meritless, and plans to file a motion to dismiss the lawsuit. He criticizes the claim as manufactured lies and irrelevant fact orchestrated by attorney Troy Blackburn, the same attorney who is handling a separate lawsuit against Sean Combs by the record producer Rodney Lil Rod Jones, right? So they are also trying to discredit this lawsuit. But really, there is no smoke without fire. That's the truth. Like father, like son, you know. There's no way you will live with someone that has been alleged to be doing all of these things that you wouldn't have been introduced. If you can introduce other people's children to it, then you can, I mean, you can imagine how he would have taught his children. So, you know, like it's always, you will definitely learn one or two things from your biological parents. Now, what are the lessons that we need to learn from this? Because it's not just about telling the stories, but it's about what we are learning. What is the learning from all of this PDD's case? And then this is son's case. Now, number one learning is accountability, taking responsibility. If you are a person in a position of power or influence, you should be aware of your responsibilities and the impact of your actions on other people. Accountability is key in all areas, particularly when your behavior can harm the other person. And if we see in all of these allegations and everything, there is no form of accountability or taking responsibility whatsoever. Right? The next thing I want to talk about is the importance of consent. All of these allegations underlie the critical importance of consent in all of your interactions. Consent must be informed, freely given, and it can be retractable at any time. Right? So you need to understand and respect the boundaries of others, as this is a fundamental to any relationship. Whether it's a business relationship, whether it's a romantic relationship, whether it's a child and parent relationship, sibling, just know that you need to understand the boundaries and you need to respect the boundaries, right? Another one I think I want to talk about is the fact that there's a lot of power dynamics at play. This story highlights how power dynamics can influence situations and behaviors. And sometimes it will lead to abuse or exploitation. So when you feel that you have power over someone, you feel that there's absolutely nothing the person can say or do, that, you know, you are above the law, you know, you are everything and this person is nothing, then it can make you behave in a certain manner, like we see that PDD is being accused of, right? So it's crucial to be aware of these dynamics and strive to create environments where everybody feels safe and everybody is respected. So all of these lawsuits are coming out as a result of lack of respect. And at some point, these people felt unsafe. And all of this happened because someone was in position of power and felt I could control, you know, anything and nothing will happen. Now, what is the significance of speaking out? Somebody spoke out, and that is why a lot of people are beginning to speak out. Victims' willingness to come forward is vital. Very, very vital for addressing and rectifying wrongdoings, right? While coming out can be incredibly challenging because you are afraid of retribution or not being believed, I tell you, if you are in this situation, speaking out is often the first step towards seeking justice and preventing further abuse. So with that, we will say a very big thank you to Cassie Ventura that came out with her lawsuit, to all the Jane Does that came out with their lawsuits, to Lil Rod that came out with ease, and then to this woman, this young lady that has just come forth with hers, right? There's a significance of speaking out. You give other people the strength to come out if they have been feeling unsafe and, you know, if they have been afraid that they are going to be attacked. You give everybody, you know, the courage to come out. And I believe these people will feel safe to come out now that they perceive that there is a, you know, there's a weakness on PDD's side, that he there's nothing he that there's no way he will run away from this, right? Another thing I see in this case is the role of bystanders. Even with the case of Cassie, there were people who knew about what was going on, but they didn't do something. The importance of you know, bystander intervention is very critical. So when witnessing any kind of inappropriate behavior or situations that could lead to harm, it's very good to take action or speak up. If you are a bystander, if you know what's going on, it's very good for you to speak up. Speaking up can, you know, provide support to those people who are in need at that time. And for those people who are in leadership positions, who have some sort of power, if you are a leader and you are in charge of organizing, or those people in charge of organizing events or gatherings, you have both a legal and moral obligation to ensure the safety of everyone. You need to ensure the safety and well-being of everyone that is, you know, that are participants, right? You can see that it was a family vacation or whatever. And Sean Combs was the one who hired the yacht. So he's responsible for everybody's safety. So it's really very critical to create environments do not enable harmful behaviors, because when you encourage harmful behavior, they can lead to severe and ethical repercussions, like what Diddy has been going through since last year. Trauma. The aftermath of SA or harassment can have long-lasting effect on the victims. I mean, we recall all that Cassie said in her own lawsuit of all the, you know, depression, anxiety. And in this woman's case, she has eating disorder. Some of them have PTSD. And even Lil Rod said he has PTSD and anxiety. So, you know, all of these people, they need a support system and they need resources to recover. I wonder where these cases are going to. I wonder what's going to come out of it, right? But I like the fact that people are coming out, people are speaking up. And I just want to leave us with this, that is, this case emphasizes the importance of ethics, respect, and responsibility in all areas of our lives. And then we need to understand that whatever we do, our children are watching. So that boy has been groomed by Diddy to be who he is today, who this lady is saying he is, allegedly, right? You know, as parents or as leaders, we have ethical responsibilities to the people that we lead or serve. And there's a need for the societies to support all of these victims. There's a need for society to enforce accountability and to strive for a culture that values safety and values the dignity of everyone. I'll keep us updated on this case. Let me know what you think about this PDD's son's case, right? They are coming out to say it's a lie. They want to discredit this lawsuit. They think that the girl is also coming out for quick cash. What do you think? Did Diddy do it? Did Diddy's son do it? Or is this just a witch hunt? I want to know what your comments are in the comment section. With that, I say thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. I will continue to update you. And just keep being who you are. keep being the best version of yourself. Learn from all these situations. You know, this is not who you are supposed to be. These characteristics are not characteristics that you need to embody, but we all need to strive to the highest version of ourselves, right? The highest version of yourself will respect another human being. The highest version of yourself will be accountable. The highest version of yourself will have respect and dignity for other people. Thank you for watching. With that, I say, have a wonderful day. I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.